Considering the five options of the organizational structures, in this lecture we are going to see the hybrid one. The hybrid structure is mainly the combination of functional and divisional structure. In fact, in the hybrid structure, both grouping criteria oriented to input and oriented to output are simultaneously used, but in different parts of the organization. Thereby, units at the first level of the organizational chart are a combination of functions and business units. Functional units are used mainly for that areas that are quite stable over time and for which the main purpose is to pursue economy of scales or economy of scope and to follow standardization. Considering a manufacturing company, typical examples might pertain to the production department, the purchasing department, or the logistics department. On the other hand, divisional units are used mainly for that areas facing a huge variety as well as complexity and that have the need to react to quick changes of market. Considering the same manufacturing company, typical examples might pertain to design and R&D department, to sales department, and sometimes to brand management and marketing department too. Staff activities are present as well, and in this case, it is a key organizational choice to define which staff activities have a company perspective and so should be managed centrally with an input purpose rather than have an output focus and so should devote it to the single business unit. For example, financial department could be centralized because controls administration and financial choices of the overall company. But quality check may be per unit because some product features require an in-depth focus on the quality control. In a hybrid structure, both coordination mechanisms typical of divisional and functional structure are used. In the output-oriented business unit, it is more likely that managers are managing activities through output standardization, whereas in input-oriented functions, through direct supervision and process standardization. This kind of organization is mainly used to blend benefits of divisional and functional organizations, as well as to mitigate, as far as possible, their weaknesses. As a matter of fact, this approach allows to pursue effectiveness for activities oriented to output, obtaining flexibility and capability of adaptation to market requests. On the other hand, the solution is able to push efficiency and economy of scales with a key focus on activities and control when these are the prevalent goals. But this configuration as well has some cons. The mix between functional and divisional criteria might create confusion about the grouping logic used to design the organization. This confusion makes it much more difficult to pursue interfunctional projects because people might have a totally different way to operate and to be evaluated in their performance. In which situation is a hybrid organizational structure preferred? As a matter of fact, this is the most adopted organizational structure in real context. In spite of the weaknesses mentioned above, companies are very likely to need a combination of different approaches in different company areas, pursued effectively through this kind of organization, especially in big companies. Thereby, this solution is typical of those companies that definitely need to have an in-depth contact with the market, because of the high number of product categories, the operation in several countries, the different characteristics of markets and customers, but are also evaluated by their capability to reduce, or at least maintain under control, their costs and so are looking for savings opportunities.